Emails in Salesforce can get a bad rep, but the fact is they're vital for selling. Every business uses email for one thing or another, and it's becoming more and more an accepted way to communicate directly with potential and existing customers. Salesforce has been through several evolutions of syncing emails with their leads, contacts, and opportunities. First, there was email to Salesforce, which honestly kind of sucked. To relate anything to Salesforce, you had to include the record ID in the subject line or body of your email, and then you had to forward that email to a special Salesforce email address. But who has time for that for all of your clients and customers? No one. So Salesforce went back and they came out with a new version, which was called Enhanced Emails, which was moderately better, but still not great. Your emails were now better formatted in Salesforce. They looked better. You could reply to emails in Salesforce and write emails in Salesforce, but you still had to sync them the same old ID forwarding way, which isn't good. Still not great. Thankfully, their third try was the best. This time, they released Einstein Activity Capture, which is designed to literally capture all the activity that you have with a customer. With this turned on, all of your emails and your calendar events will be synced automatically with Salesforce. No need to add IDs or send emails to a weird address. It just looks for an account, a contact, a contract, a lead, an opportunity, or even a quote that has the same email as the one that you are sending. And then it's just going to link the two together. How awesome is that? The biggest restriction here is that Einstein Activity Capture only works for Google and Outlook accounts. So if you're not a Microsoft user or a Gmail user, then sorry, but you're straight out of luck here. To set up Einstein Activity Capture, you first need to give your users access to it through a permission set. Next, you need to walk through the Einstein Activity Capture flow. But you can do this easily by searching for Einstein Activity Capture in Setup, and then just following the instructions from there. When you're walking through those instructions, you can decide how you want your email data to sync with Salesforce. Should the sync go two ways? So your Salesforce data syncs with your email and your email syncs with Salesforce? Or do you just want it to go one directional? You can also choose to exclude certain email addresses, so you're not syncing family or personal emails, and decide whether users can share their emails and events with each other. Once you're happy with all of the default settings that have been set up on the admin side, your end users can then go ahead and connect their own email accounts themselves. All they need to do is go into personal settings, click on connected accounts, and then add in their own email. All synced and ready to go. Email templates are the last part of syncing emails with the user. All users can create their own private templates, and they can access templates in public folders. There are two ways to create email templates in Salesforce. Way number one is to use Lightning email templates, and way number two is to use the email template builder. The email template builder has a nicer interface of the two, and it's my personal favorite. To find it, users need to navigate to the email templates object in their Salesforce app, and then just select New. From here, they can create their own email templates and use the really cool drag and drop functionality to add things like merge fields, images, themes, colors, and icons. Lightning email templates are a faster way to create templates than the builder, but they give less options for design. You can create these straight from the email tab in the activities related list, and you can insert merge fields without leaving the same page. Regardless of where you make your templates, you can save them publicly or privately, depending on each user's permissions. For a user to use another email template, they must have access to the folder that that template is saved in. That's a wrap on emails for users in Salesforce. We've covered the different ways that users can sync their emails with Salesforce, how you can set it up, and the two different methods for creating email templates. Now, go forth and communicate with the world.